It was a special day for the man behind the blinds. His name was Scott Randall, and this was the day he was scheduled to die by lethal injection. Randall was bad to the bone. Three people died by his hand, and you don't want to know how.
What are you doing, Skippy?
The families of his victims were there to make sure he got what was coming. A two-bit actor when he wasn't killing anyone, Randall relished his final role.
Slip the juice to me, Bruce.
A lethal injection involves a number of drugs. The first, sodium pentothal, is supposed to knock the inmate out, and then potassium chloride finishes him off.
Here comes death.
But there was a hitch.
Nothing. I don't feel a thing. Nothing!
Even with enough drugs in his system to drop a rhino, Randall's heart didn't skip a beat.
Nada.
I think that this guy wasn't Superman, and that the reason that he stayed alive was because the tourniquet was too tight on his arm and the drug wasn't able to flow past the injection site to his heart where it was supposed to go.
The authorities were mystified.
Please, sir, then the order came in.
Release him.
Scott Randall, convicted murderer and lifetime scum, had a new lease on life.
Nothing to it. You couldn't kill me. You couldn't kill me, son of a bitches!
But in the middle of his fury, Randall went down. And then out. Once unstrapped, the drugs found the one thing most swore Randall never had, a heart, and finished him off.
When you deliver drug, you always take the tourniquet off. Otherwise, there is no drainage of the compound into the central circulation. It was just sitting in his arm.
It's hard to justify one death with another, but a creep like Scott Randall, he deserved to die.